know what that says about me.
Oh, right.
Where do I stay here?
You have to stand right at the top.
Okay.
Oh, it looks so gorgeous.
You look fabulous, Ollie. Doesn't she look fabulous? Bitch.
Mm-hmm. 3:09 p.m. All the housemates, apart from blushing bride Shell, have changed into their wedding outfits.
Oh my God! Oh, my little soul, God! I want to get married!
So do I. I want to get being a bride.
Have you ever been married?
Twice.
Twice?
Shut up. I've never been married. But actually, that. Because I know stuff about weddings.
No, it's just the kind of thing you'd expect of somebody, you know, of a certain age.
You ever been married?
What? No.
Well, I know guys that were married and had kids who were gay.
Yeah, but that's not me, is it?
Like, well, that's not a silly question, isn't it? You could have thought you were straight, been married, had a kid, and then realised you were gay. No. Well, I know guys that have done that.
Yeah, but I know you're not gay, Jason.
But I know guys that have done that, though.
Eh?
I know guys that have done that.
Yeah. So what you say, that you're gay?
Who?
You.
Do I look gay?
Well, exactly. Well, yeah. Well, that's another argument altogether. Most guys I was at school with have been married now.
Oh, my mates aren't they married?
They're not married?
No.
Right.
It's not about what age has got fuck all to do. It just depends what sort of person you are. Mm. If you want to lead your life first before
yeah, I
down.
Know that. I'm just saying, no, like, in general, yeah. Like, most guys by the age of 30 are married. Or have been married.
It's best to enjoy your life first and then get married. You can obviously you can enjoy it when you get married, but there's a bit more pressure on you when you get married, isn't there? You kind of just be footless and fancy free, man, and take to the hills whenever you want, man. Peezy. What about you on, Slick?
No thanks, mate.
Respect happiness and peace.
<laughs> 4:26 p.m. It's just over an hour until the Big Brother wedding. Michelle is in the garden. Daniel's on the decking. As best man, Daniel will be required to deliver the best man speech. Stuart, the father of the bride, and Victor are practicing their speeches in the living area.
I was first attracted to your sexy long bronze fires and your wavy flowing blonde locks.
Michelle, Shell and Nadia are talking about Victor in the bedroom.
Why is Victor not even look? Have you all had words or something?
Nothing at all. TD's gay, my best friend, saying
he's always been like nominated him.
Well, whether I have or not,
yeah.
There's a pretty rude way
What's
to
that?
Do it. I've always been nice to him, but he has always been the person who's come up to me and sort of said, oh, morning, princess, or how are you doing, or this and the other. And then he goes on about people being fake or trying to be mates with everyone. Literally, 2 days ago, he was absolutely friendly to me, and then today and yesterday, nothing. Like, thinks I'm the worst person in the world and hasn't said anything.
Thing is, it's almost like it's unfair for it to be up to you to say, look, what's going on. It's unfair.
I'm not gay.
Exactly.
So I don't really care, to be honest. I don't like needy people like that. No. And I'm not going to go, oh, what's wrong?
He wants to get something off his chest, that's fair enough. He should say something. They're playing a game, we're all playing a game, right, let's face it. But they think that they've got some kind of amazing tactic, mm-hmm. And obviously they feel like it's worked because of not being nominated until now, right? They feel like it's worked.
You're in here and you can either choose to be fucking awful to everyone or get on with it and just sort of think, well, perhaps you're not my absolute cup of tea. But, you know, in this situation where we're stuck together, we may as well try and get on.
Mm-hmm.
Try.
They're thinking, she's not going to nominate one of the girls. She's not going to nominate Dan. She's not going to have nominated Stu. She's nominated us too.
Yeah, well, get over it, because they probably nominated me at some point.
Exactly.
5:41 p.m. The bride's wedding party are in the bedroom.
Oh, my darling.
Hello, Stu.
Where is this bird?
It's gonna get emotional soon.
No, mate, you're marrying her.
It would have been really weird if it was you and Michelle. That would have been odd. Yeah.
Oh my god, I'm gonna go
open
the gate.
Right. Open doors, do you?
Might want to take a step back, Joe. We're gonna come under there.
Clergyman Jason must now deliver the service.
Ding dong!
Thanks, Dexter.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today in the presence of these witnesses to join in matrimony Victor and Shell. The joining of two people in the eyes of God shall be blessed with love and last forever. There is nothing more sacred than the love and happiness that two people share together. Please be seated for the vows.
Thank you.
That's beautiful, man. Thank
you. It's lovely.
Do you, Shell Glenn Dubin, take Victor Anthony Ebuer to be your wedded husband?
I do.
I'll make love to you when you want me to.
I'll make love to you when you want me to.
And I'll hold you tight, baby, all through the night.
And I'll hold you tight, baby, all through the night.
Do you, Victor Anthony Bua, take Shell Glenn Dubin to be your wedded wife?
I do.
I'll make love to you when you want me to.
I'll make love to you when you want me to.
And I'll hold you tight, baby, all through the night.
And I'll hold you tight. Baby, all through the night.
And I will not let you go till you tell me so.
And I won't let you go till you tell me so.
Thanks, Vic.
Maybe have the rings, please.
As bridegroom, Victor has not recited his vows word for word. He has incurred the group's second feel.
And if Shell, she could please. She's a moment.
I'm so happy.
I will now have the chorister to sing Pie Jesu.
Pie Jesu, Pie Jesu, Pie Jesu, Pie Jesu. Good Holy et Mundi, Domine et Requiem, Domine Requiem. Agnus Dei, Agnus Dei, Agnus Dei, Agnus Dei. Domine et Requiem, Domine et Requiem.
Michelle's version of Pie Jesu has not been performed to the tune that Big Brother provided. The housemates have now incurred their third fail. One more fail, and the housemates will fail this week's task.
I now pronounce you man and wife. You may now kiss the bride.
Oh, thanks, Vic.
Oh, no, no.
I'll give you half of it.
This
is a farce.
Right. Oh, I can't believe you ruined it. I'm gonna